Ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome back to our channel. And today I am presenting a small presentation on COBOL program structure. In today's presentation, I'll explain what are the different divisions in a COBOL program and what is the significance of each division. So before I start with today's presentation, I would request you all to do subscribe to our channel because we need your support to grow our channel. Apart from that, I would like to say a big thanks to each one of you who have already subscribed to our channel. And do watch this video till the end because last section has a detailed explanation of a COBOL program. So let's begin with our today's presentation. COBOL introduction. COBOL stands for Common Business Oriented Language. It is a high-level programming language which is used to design business-oriented applications. COBOL is simple, robust, and easy to learn English-like programming language. It is one of the oldest programming languages that still dominates the enterprise computing. Now let's move on to next section that explains the basic elements of the program structure. Now in this section, I have created a bottom-up flowchart that shows the relationship between each and every element that contributes towards the entire program structure. So at the bottom, you have a statement. And when statements are combined with variables, it forms a sentence. One or more sentences when combined logically into a group is called as paragraph. And the logical grouping of paragraph is known as section. And a program division can have one or more section. In fact, if you want, you can skip sections, you can have paragraph only. So that depends on the programmer and the requirement of the project. So now let's move on to next section that explains the different section of a COBOL program. Okay, so as I've already mentioned that COBOL is an English-like language and a COBOL program is actually divided into four different divisions and each division has a specific meaning. I will explain these divisions one by one in coming slides, but as of now, only remember that there are four divisions in a COBOL program. So first one is identification division, then you have environment division, then you have data division, and the last one is procedure division, which is actually having your entire logic. So now let's move on to next section as of now, that is COBOL coding format. COBOL is a high-level programming language. And a COBOL source program has to be written in a specific format so that compiler can process it. Each line is considered to be of 80 columns and these columns are divided into 5 fields. Position number 1 to 6 is used for sequence number and that is used during 1960s, 70s and 80s when the punch card is used. Position number 7 is used for continuation and comments. Position number 8 to 11 is known as Area A and that is used for special entries such as data division, sections, etc. Position number 12 to 72 is known as Area B and that is primarily used to include various COBOL reserved words and the sentences. The last one is 73 to 80 is generally used during the old days. It's no more use. Normally in certain projects it's used for tagging your changes. So now let's move on to next section where you'll get a clear idea of how exactly a COBOL program looks. So here is the basic structure of a COBOL program. So if you look at the top section, I have clearly marked the positions, that is each line is divided into 80 columns and what is the significance of each position. So if you see the first one, that is 1 to 6 is for sequence number, which is not used anymore. On position number 7, you have comments. If you look at the program itself, so there is asterisk and then the comments have been included. And from position number 8 to 11, that is for area A, which is actually a starting point for your division. For example, identification division, environment division, data division, working storage section. So these are actually starting in area A. And from position number 12 to 72 is actually where you're going to write various COBOL sentence or syntaxes, right? And at the last, which is actually from 73 to 80, is again used for tagging or for identification, but now it's no more use. Okay, so if you look at the first section, that is number one is identification division. So this is one section where you're just going to write the name of the program, when it is, who is the author who has written that, where exactly is the compilation date. So we're going to talk about all these sections in detail. Second section is environment section, which is actually used to specify what are the input output files that you will be using. Third one is data division, which is actually used to specify the definitions of file, what is the structure of a file, what are the working storage variables that you'll be using in your program. And the last one is procedure division. This is the place, this is the section where you're going to write your complete logic. And in this program, I'm printing the name of an employee. So if you see the output, if you run this program, you'll have an output that says name of an employee is Roger Murphy. Now let's move on to next section, that is a detailed explanation of each section. So first we're going to start with identification division. So identification division is basically the first section of a COBOL program, and it is generally used for documentation purpose. In this section you generally define what is the name of your program, who is the author of this program, what is the date when it was written, when it was compiled, and a short description, okay, what exactly this program is doing. Please remember that identification division is one of the mandatory section of COBOL program, and in that section program ID is something that you always need to provide. You can skip the other parameters because they are optional. So now let's move on to next section, which is an example of an identification division. So clearly you can understand from this example that how exactly you have to write your identification division. So in this case, identification division was started in area A, that is from position number 8, if you look at I. And similarly, other parameters also start in area A. So program ID is a mandatory parameter. You need to specify the program name in this section, and rest all are optional. Okay, so now let's move on to the next section, that is environment division. So let's talk about environment section, which is actually an optional section, and it is again further divided into subsections, that is configuration section and input output section. So let's discuss about all these section in details. So configuration section is generally used to provide computer details on which the source program is written and to which the object of that particular program is designated. Apart from that, the second section is input output section. This is actually used for providing file level details. And in case if you are not using any file for any input output operation, then generally this particular section is left blank. Now let's look at the example so that you can clearly understand how exactly you need to define the entries in this particular section. So if you look at the example, in source and object computer, I've just provided IBM ZOS. So this is something that will depend on your project and client, and normally this is an optional parameter, so normally you can skip that. The second important section is input output section, where you generally define the file details. For example, in my case, I'm using print file. So this is the name I would be referring in my COBOL program, and UPD is actually a DD name which would be used to attach this file to a physical file which will be passed through a JCL. Okay, so now let's move on to the next division, that is data division. So data division is another important section of a COBOL program, and this section is generally used to define the working storage variables and file structure. In total, this section is divided into 7 different sections. So let's discuss each section one by one. So the first section is file section, where you need to define the entries of a file if you're using any file. Next section is working storage section. This is used to define the working storage variables that you'll be using in your program. Third section is a local storage section, and that is again used to define variables that would be allocated and reinitialized every time the program is invoked. Fourth section is a linked section. This section is actually used to define variables when you want to pass value from one program to other subprogram. Next section is a communication section, and it is used to create a control block required for communication. Next section is a report section, and it is generally used to define report descriptor entries, which is required for report writer module. And the last section is a screen section. which is used to describe labels and data items which are required for formatting input-output in case of application programs developed for personal computers. Now let's look at the example of data division, and in this section I have actually defined the structure of print file, and I hope you remember that in my previous slide I have actually defined the actual entries for the print file. And similarly, in the working storage section I have actually defined few variables that I'll be using in my procedure division. So now let's move on to next section, which is actually a procedure division. So procedure division is the last section of this section. Actually includes the entire logic of your program. In fact, all your statements, your paragraph, all your sections reside in this particular section. Now let's quickly look at the example so that you can understand how exactly the procedure division looks. So if you look at the example of procedure division, you have a paragraph called A000-main. So this is the main paragraph, which is actually having a logic of printing an employee name in spool or in the output. Now let's move on to the last section of this presentation, and that is a line by line explanation of a COBOL program. So this is a sample program that I have written for this particular presentation, and this program is actually printing the name of an employee in the output or in spool if you're running that on mainframe. So in this particular program, what I've done is I've just removed the top section, which is explaining column by column, because that is not required, and I've divided this entire program into two sections. Section A is normally for line numbers and all, and section B is actual from position number 7 till 72. So if you look at this, first section is an identification division, which is actually for documentation section. Environment division is actually for defining your files, computer related details. Moving to section 3, that is data division, which is actually used to define your file structure. So in this case I'm not using any file, so I've just kept it blank. If you want, you can just omit that. It is not required to include that particular file section over there. So in working storage I've included two variables, because I would be moving the employee name to that, and then I would be printing to my spool. And similarly in procedure division I've included my logic. So if you see 000 main logic, so this is basically a main paragraph, and in this I would be using a statement called perform a specific paragraph name. So perform is actually used to execute a specific logic for certain conditions, right? And similarly, if you look at 005-PRT-EMP-data space section, so this is actually a section which is actually a group of certain logical group paragraph. And if you see 010 move data, so this is actually a paragraph which is actually moving the employee name to the temporary variables. Similarly, you have another paragraph that says 020-PRT-data, so this is again a paragraph which would be printing the employee name to the spool. So when you run this program, it will print name of employee as Roger Murphy. So this marks an end to our today's presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching this particular presentation till the end. And in case if you have any feedback, then do mention in the comment section. We'll incorporate that in our next videos. Apart from that, in case if you have any question, then please do mention in the comment section. We will going to respond back to your questions. Apart from that, I would request you all that please do subscribe to our channel, because we need your support to grow this channel. Once again, thank you so much and stay safe.